Hello, folks, and once again, welcome to the Hour of the Time. It's Friday, and I know that there are a lot of places where you would like to be other than by your radio. But this is an important program. It is so important that I urge you to stick it out, listen to it. In my travels around this country, I've found that this is one ingredient missing from most of the homes throughout this country, yet this is the ingredient that allows us to have the homes that we have around this country.
One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The purpose of this show, The Hour of the Time, is to acquaint everyone worldwide with the ideals and the principles that this country, the United States of America, was founded upon, and to re-educate those who have forgotten those principles and those ideals. Because I believe that there's a cancer growing in the world today, one that is propelling us into a new world, totalitarian socialist order. And I believe that can only happen because of the apathy, the abdication of responsibility, and the ignorance of all of the people of the world who will allow this to happen. Values are falling by the wayside. It is now good to do wrong and wrong to do good. It is the purpose of this program to reacquaint the world with the principles that finally set men free. You see, before the establishment of the Constitution of the United States of America and its Bill of Rights, all people in the entire world belonged to someone else. They belonged to the Pope, or to the King, or to their master, or to some lord, or to some sultan. But no one in the entire history of the world had ever been truly free. With the establishment of the Constitution of the United States of America and this nation, man had reached the pinnacle of all the striving of humankind throughout history and stood as a sovereign king in his own right, with the government for the first time ever in the history of the world as his chattel servant. Now we see the roles going back to the old way, reversing once again, where the government is becoming all powerful and man is once again being relegated to the position of property of someone or something else. And it is only because we have forgotten. When you see children who seem aimless, who seem to have no hope, who are pursuing a life of crime and degradation, it is because they do not understand those principles. It's because they see no hope. They see no future. They see no way out of the trap that they have been relegated into. Listeners, it does not make any difference who I am or where I come from. It makes a difference what I stand for. So that you will not fall into the trap of the disinformation artists who will attempt to discredit everything that I am saying because they do not want these principles to be remembered. Think of me as the worst possible human being that you can imagine, a bank robber, a murderer, someone who's committed the most dastardly of crimes, and then listen to the information that you hear on this program. weigh that information on its own merits. And do not believe a thing that you hear on this show, or on the 6 o'clock news, or on the BBC, or on Radio Moscow, from George Bush, from Mr. Gorbachev, or from your own mother. For the deception in the world that's being promulgated by those who would change the world is so deep that indeed short people are in danger of drowning. It is my hope that the information that you hear on this show, which will consist mainly of suppressed information that you will never, ever hear in the mainstream media of any country, will help to set us free. I believe in the saying of a great man, seek ye the truth, and the truth shall set you free. I believe that information is the power of the 90s, not money. And I believe that those who are well informed and those who read and absorb information on a great scale from every source, not just the source that you subscribe to, or just the beliefs that you subscribe to, but from every source that there is. And don't discount the information put out by your enemies, simply because to win a battle, you must know your enemy. And the one who has the most information usually will emerge as the victor. I want to thank all of those people who have helped me throughout the years. I would also like to thank all the wonderful people at WWCR in Nashville, Tennessee, who have helped to make this show become a reality. For it is only when you can reach large numbers of people throughout the world that a message is able to transcend all of the blocks and the obstacles put before it. This is not a religious show. And I will not preach to you ever. But religion will enter into the discussion on many of these shows simply because at the root of what is happening today are religious events that happened centuries ago, and they must be addressed. Tonight you are going to hear the Living Constitution. Get out your tape recorders and make sure you have a pencil and paper with you all throughout this show so that you can jot down notes at the break. And at the end of the show, I'm going to give you some phone numbers and an address that you need to write to. I believe that you cannot understand any of the information that you are going to get in the coming weeks and months and years on this program without a knowledge of the Constitution of the United States of America and all of the amendments thereof. No matter what country you live in or what language you speak, record this broadcast. Listen to it over and over again, and then you will understand why the United States of America was such a great, great nation, and why it is declining in its greatness now, that people have forgotten these principles, and most Americans do not have a copy of the Constitution, and indeed, do not even know what it says.